Hello everybody, this is Alpha Woofie, Awoo, and I'm on the XBOX One, and I'm playing the Halo 5 multiplayer beta. Sometimes I do Fridays, sometimes I do Saturdays, sometimes I do both, sometimes I do neither. Either way, 10 PM UK time, Google convert that if you need to. Taking that in all together, follow me on Twitch, and you will get the email sent to you. For otherwise, just follow the schedule. Like I say, don't always hold me to it. And automatically, it's connected to my Twitter, and sometimes I post on Fur Affinity. Not all the time, because I don't want to bother them as much. And like I say, it's been a long time, so I hope you lot had a good Christmas and a Happy New Year. If not, I'm sorry, but hopefully this year will be better for you. So I'm trying to basically get back into this whole Twitch gaming and all that stuff. So, do forgive me if I'm a little bit rusty. Anyway, like I say, I'm playing Halo 5 multiplayer beta, and it's on the XBOX One. Also, the fact that I have the XBOX dashboard preview, you can sign up for that, I think, and you would have had this game released. The beta version, at least, released early on. Wasn't giving you much time to play it, though, but it was like a very quick preview. Now, that'll be under my Twitch highlights, so if you want to search for that, it'll be under the Alpha Wolfie Halo 5 Beta Part 1. Also, that'll be also under my YouTube, which my YouTube channel will be 1978 Wolfie. 1978WOLFIE. So that's 1978 Wolfie. Find that channel, that's where I am as well. But like I say, follow me on Twitch, you will get the emails and all that stuff. It goes on and on and on. But in the Halo 5 Part 1, I basically got the XBOX dashboard preview, then they gave them that early release. But now it's back on to the game, which is the Master Chief Collection, which is Halo 1, Halo 2, Halo 3, Halo 4. And soon to be Halo ODST, something like that. ODST, OS, on the keyboard, it's that. But yeah, they'll be bringing that. Because the multiplayer was broken on the game completely, and they're going to give it to those people who got the game on day release and a few weeks before that, all that whole mess up. I don't know if I'll have it or not, because they say you had to be logged on. That's ambiguous, and they're saying you have to be on the multiplayer. I didn't play the multiplayer, but I think I logged on. So hopefully, I mean, if not, you could still buy it. It won't be extraordinary, so it was there. But with this game, with the Master Chief Collection on Halo, 343 Studios has added Halo 1, which has been remastered, which was also on the XBOX 360, but it's making a welcome return again. Now, Halo 2 has now had its revamp, which is basically the game, you have the old edition and a newer version, bringing the HD quality up and the resolutions and all that stuff, making the game look a bit smoother and prettier, hypothetically. It still has its little bugs, but you know, for all it's worth, it's great. And also the cutscenes have been totally revamped. So you can really flick through the old version and the new version very quickly, whereas the 360 version, it took some time. But with Halo 2, it wasn't on there, it was just the Halo 1. Okay, and then you have the Halo 3 and Halo 4, which have not had an update, because they say it doesn't need it as yet. I'm sure they'll do that as the years go on. And so on. But anyway, they've been just put up to good sharp quality, running smoothly. And they have all the multiplayer maps from those games. So it's a great addition to go and get. If you haven't got it, get it. It's, you know, four games in one. How many times do you get it? Okay, so for the people who have played it and all the way through, it's maybe not so as great, but it's a welcome addition. For those who haven't, you're in heaven. Anyway, this is the beta version. This is the second part, which will be in this game from the Master Chief Collection. You have the beta. So I'm going to give it a go. So pre-release software, thank you for helping create, test, improve Halo 5 guidance by participating in the Arena Multiplayer Beta. This beta is a snapshot of our work in progress and prone to normal game development issues. You see glitches, hitches, and even crashes. Some Xbox Live features may not work correctly. Since this software is pre-release code, we cannot provide customer support in the traditional sense. However, data and feedback as you play and enjoy the game will help you us improve and enhance the final product. Your contributions are an inevitable part of our success. Thank you for your patience, and we'll see you on the battleground. 343 Industries. So there we go. So let's jump into it. Halo 5 Guardians Arena Multiplayer Data. Beta. That B looks a bit badish. Yeah. Goof that up. Duh. Message of the day. This week, play Slayer on a Forge map selected by you. You'll also be able to play a new objective game type called Strongholds on Regret or Empire. Let's go. So here we are. Now you have your multiplayer beta, your Halo channel, your Spartan Hub, and the message of the day. Now for this, I'll switch on the mute so that I do not disturb the multiplayer people who are playing the game and they're thinking, what's this person talking to? I ask myself that. Zero people watching this Twitch. It's okay. If not, you probably might get it on the highlights. Lazy people. How dare you? And also on the YouTube. So it's there. It's fine. But if you do come in here, you're welcome to chat as long as you abide by the rules of being polite and respectful. And while playing the game, or if you're just viewing it and you've got the comment section, just jot things down. Trollolol. We're used to that, so hopefully you can be more constructive. I'm not a professional, people. My gameplay will probably suck in this game, as you probably saw from the last time. So please forgive me for my rubbishness. It's one of those things. I mean, it's mostly in all games. I mean, some people home into one game like, really, you know. And people like me struggle because I'm like a general person. I like to jump on and have fun. Do what I can, do the best that I can, if not, oh well. So, without further ado, I will just have it on mute. And you're welcome to leave comments. And once I finish playing a one match game, or whatever it is, I might be able to read out your comments, inform you about anything you want to know about my Twitch channel, or my YouTube channel, games, films, comics. What's your interest? Please do write them in the comments or in the chat room. It's welcomed, as long as it's respectful. It goes without saying. And I've waffled on. I mean, I'll try to, you know, waffle on now, because from when I play, I'll be pretty much on mute. Like I said, I don't want to disturb people on a multiplayer and thinking I'm a complete loony, which I probably am. So, you know, sit back, get comfortable, and we'll be starting very shortly. Okay, so the feature playlists. Slayer. Trying to send that voice. Halo 5 Guardians. New take on the classic Slayer. Map control and communications are key to victory. Week 3. Players start with both the assault rifle and the battle rifle. Team player 4 versus 4. Min players 8. Party size limit 4. Feature playlist Breakout. Fast and competitive mode with no respawns. First team to win 5 rounds wins the match. Team play 4 versus 4. Min players 8. Party size limit 4. Strongholds. Control 2 strongholds to score points for your team. First team to 100 points wins the match. Team play 4 versus 4. Minimum players 8. Party size limit 4. So there you go. Strongholds, Breakout, Slayer. Okay, so there's your games, and I'll be playing those. So hopefully I'll get through that one. That one, we'll see. Okay. So bear with me, sit back, leave your comments, follow me on my Twitch, if not YouTube, view the videos, leave your comments, be in the chat, be a part of the community, and happy gaming. I'll be starting very shortly. Okay, everybody, I'm back. I do apologize. I give that a little break, so if you need to go to the toilet or want to go on your Twitter or whatever you want to do socially, that's fine. I usually do give people a little break here and there. So let's go on with it, and like I say, I'll keep the mute button on so you get the full experience. Slayer.
Control power weapons to dominate the enemy team.
Thank you.
enemy halfway to victory.
Pinged one.
Nice shot.
DMR.
Enemy team nearing victory. 5 minutes remain. Over. Defeat. control power weapons to dominate the enemy team.
Stay sharp.
Rockets are up.
Shields are back.
We've got the rocket launcher.
Watch the nade! Readying rocket. Security.
Sniper rifle in 30 seconds.
Kill.
sniper rifle in 30 seconds. Power weapons in 30 seconds.
Enemy grenade! Back to headshot.
Seconds to sniper rifle. Power weapon still 10 seconds. On the field. You're ready.
2 minutes left.
Got the rocket launcher.
Game over. Defeat.
So there you go, people. That was Slayer. I did awful. As always, I do apologize about that, but you got to see the two maps there. And that's the Slayer player, which is basically just shooting everybody and see who wins. There's another thing. I used to be good at these sort of games. But is anyone you come off from the, say, the campaign and what have you, that you do actually realise you're actually playing with random people who can go left and right and up and down and stay in one spot, whereas the AI player will probably pretty much stay in its area and react somewhat accordingly to you. But it's a whole ball and kettle when you're playing with other people. Other people will camp, other people will have better weapons, upgrades, you name it. It's not always easy as it used to be. So that was Slayer. With Halo 5 Guardians, take on new classic multiplayer map, communications to victory, three player start with both assault rifle and battle rifle. And then we'll go on to Breakout, which is fast and competitive mode with no respawn. First team to win 5 rounds wins the match. So this game's pretty much what you expect, as everybody will be hiding. And what's the point hiding when you actually gotta kill people? But that's what skilled players will do. They will just wait it out. But saying that, you've also got to kill people. So it's a hit and miss whether you just camp out and wait for that golden opportunity and hit or miss, or you go ballsy out and help your team a little bit. I mean, it's kind of suicidal, but it might pay off a little bit more. It's either or, and you pretty much can tell which one kind of wins slightly, because if you stake it out and move about a little bit, it's no good point staying about. It's best to stick together somewhat. I mean, if you stick together completely, you're all up for grabs. it's a bit of a mind game when you're playing those sort of things where it's no respawns. So this is Breakout, and I'll be playing that very shortly. So if you want to leave your comments, that you thick, tell me what I know already. I'm just basically showing you these are some of the maps that are coming out and the gameplay and the whole feel to it. Most people were saying this is more like Call of Duty style with Halo in mind. Do I feel like this is the case? Somewhat, yeah. But I much prefer it like this. With the, I don't know, Halo 3 and Halo 4, it kind of bumped everything, where you're super powerful and you can fly up into the air, or you can just create a cloud of shield. Everything. Some people just maxed it out to the best, and it was just for the elites, if you call them that. And it kind of took away the people who just want to jump in, like myself, who would do absolutely awful but still have a fighting chance. Whereas I think 3 and 4 were a little bit more added extras and too much complications, but people who got it. So we'll be going on to Breakout. So, like I say, I'll give you a few minutes. If you want to subscribe to my YouTube, if you're already on it, please do. I don't just play this, I'll be playing other games. At the moment, I'm doing Skylanders Trap Team. And I've got two more new additions. They are, if I can read it right, Tough Luck, which is, I think, a life element. She's like a sort of a female anthropomorphic cat, I would have guessed, tigress, slightly. Yeah, so I'll have her. And I've also got, I don't know what you call it, I think it's called Earth type elements, but he's called Wallop. They're the two new Skylanders, so hopefully I'll get to test them out, who knows. I do also have Wildfire, and the other character looks like a crocodile. So those are the game I will be playing as well, so Skylanders Trap Team. I'm also doing another game. I'm trying to remember this. It's like I'm saying, trying to get back to the whole gaming thing. But at the moment, I'm playing Alien Isolation Ripley Edition, and that's also under my highlights and my YouTube channel, which I did Crew Expendable and Last Survivor. I jumped right into the deep end. I did not play the campaigns. So, and to be honest, I did those in about, altogether in about just under 2 hours, just under 2 hours with both those DLCs. So it's like, they're pretty short. So right now I'm playing the campaign. I'm loving it. It's a very slow-paced game. It's a very stealth game. So there you go. And also for the Christmas period, I had Shape Up, which is done by the company called Rare, who's responsible for Conker's Bad Fur Day, Banjo-Kazooie, and a whole little bunch of games. They were responsible also for doing Shape Up. Not Shape Up. Kinect Sports Rivals. Oh, I had that one. I have not played it as of yet. Basically, I got that game because I went over to my cousin's for Christmas, Boxing Day. And basically, all we did was played Shape Up. Shape Up is basically just exhausting. It's constantly running up and down, and it does elements of keep fitting, but it's more of an endurance with added fun elements. More of the fun side, where Kinect Sports Rivals has the more sporty side, of course. And they both use the Kinect. So I was playing those as well. I've still yet to play the Disney Fantasia Music Evolved. I've played a bit of the campaign, but not as much. And I've downloaded all the DLC because I wanted all the music. And it's so much easier. All you have to do is wave your arms around in a specific motion and fluidity and pushing arms forward. It's more laid back. It's interesting, to say the least. But I've recently completed Evil Within on the Xbox One. That's a game I do recommend. It plays out like a bit like the Saw movies, which is an 18, so if you're underage, don't. But, you know, most of you lot will have it. So basically, Saw is basically traps and completely decapitations. And that's how it kind of plays out. It's nitty gritty, it's hack slash. Yeah, it goes on there, and then it goes strangely into complete warped areas. 1 minute you're in the hospital, next minute you're in the graveyard, next minute you're here, there, and everywhere. It tries too much confusion, and I get the whole idea that your mind's losing the plot and all that stuff. And I'm not trying to give it away, but anyway, from there on, it goes into more of a Resident Evil style, where the monsters are gooey and zombie-ified, and the whole eyeballs, which they have fantasized about, and it's something to do with Resident Evil, the whole eyeballs and all that stuff, but it's all there. So I completed that, and I thought, money worth. Okay, so I do recommend that game. But future plans. Oh god, I'm forgetting, sorry. I'm doing Skylanders Swap. Not Swap Force, I didn't that. Trying to remember everything. So fickle. Skylanders Trap Team. I'm doing that at the moment. And also, I'll be trying to complete Stick It to the Man. So, those two games I'll try and plod along. Stick It to the Man, I'm more or less trying to complete because I'm near to the end part. So, if you want to stick around with that, haha. Lame. That'll be on the plans for my Twitch and also posting onto YouTube. But what I would hope to be able to play and show you is The Wolf Among Us, which, if you haven't seen it, you can search up on YouTube. Basically, I played it the way I wanted to play. I wanted to play the tough guy doing things right. So hopefully with this second time round, I'll be playing him badly. I don't know how well it'll turn out. But I had that game on the 360. And I've got it on the Xbox One, so I can play on Twitch. Because at the moment, I only have Twitch for the Xbox One. I'm not going to get the capture card because I don't have the memory for the laptop. Laptop is an XP version. It's way old, and the memory's all clogged up. And yes, you can get hard drive and all that, but it'll be no good. So the whole capture card and the whole thing will not be in the regime. And plus, different games, different computers, connections. I can't be doing it. This is why I like the Xbox One, because it has Twitch and the whole app, and once you log in and all that stuff, yeah, it starts off a bit complicated, but once you're in, you're in, and you can do things like this. But yeah, I hope to play Wolf Among Us and The Walking Dead Season 1 and 2. We'll see how it goes. But yeah, I've recently got the Wii U. And you go, what, the Wii U? Well, I've got the Xbox One. If I'm getting the PS4, people, I'll be getting pretty much the same cross-platforming games. The only difference will be the exclusives, and I prefer these exclusives. I like the Halos, I like the... well, hopefully Gears of War, who knows? They could do some... I heard that it's not been done by the same people, but anyway. But yeah, there, I like their games. Forza Horizon 2, brilliant. Halo, brilliant. Gears of War, brilliant. Not yet, but it'll be on the cards. And there's loads of other games. So I do enjoy the Xbox One. I'm sorry, the PS4. I have nothing against it. Like I said, I've got the Wii U. I also have the PlayStation 3. I come from the games of the Atari and the Commodore 64 and the Sega Genesis or Mega Drive, if you like to call it, the Mega CD, the Sega Saturn, the Dreamcast, the Game Boy Black and White, Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Game Boy 3DS. Oh, goodness. Loads. So I do like my consoles, I do like my games. And the whole console war, please stop. Enjoy your games. Respect the other people for what they like and pay for with their own hard money. That's how I see it. Anyway, we'll be jumping onto Breakout very shortly. So if you want to hit that follow button on Twitch, do so. If not, go to the link, it'll be on my YouTube channel. And if you're already there, do it now. If not, you're also, if you're watching this on YouTube, follow, subscribe, you know, you get that. It's, I hate doing it, people, hate it. Telling you what to do. But we are drones and robots at the end of the day. We do what we want and we can undo what we want. It's perfectly fine. As long as I can get to entertain and get to show people out there, why not? And you can do it too. So, Breakout very shortly. Hello everybody, I'm back. So for the break, I do like to give people a little break, and you can leave your comments and you can go on your media and apps and stuff like that. So we're going for Breakout.
Eliminate all enemy players to win the round. Round one.
Hostile down.
4-on-3.
Down, blue
back out. 3-on-2. 2-on-2. 1-on-2. Duel. Round lost. 1-2. Round 4.
Move fast and stay low.
Standing. 1-on-3. round lost. 1-3. Round 5.
Work together and we'll take this.
Red Rampart is taking damage.
4-3. Duel. You won the round. 2-3. Round 6.
Call out targets and stay mobile.
You won the round. 3-3. Round 7.
Work together and we'll take this. Left. Game over. Defeat.
eliminate all enemy players to win the round. Round one.
Go, go, go!
Last man standing. One on two.
So that was Breakout, people. yeah, absolutely rubbish. But I actually enjoyed that. I liked the maps. They were simple. Neon effect, very futuristic. And I liked the challenge. It wasn't so much as camping as I thought, because basically they've done it pretty much in an open field. There are things in the way, but for the most part, it would be a good idea to run around. I love that beginning part where you just run, go up the ramp and jump up in the air and land onto your platform. That was a very good introduction going into the game. That was very good. Slayer was okay. I mean, the maps were definitely bright and colourful and varied. So there's a lot for that game. I mean, it'll be interesting to see how that one goes, but I think most people will go into Breakout. But let's have a look at Strongholds. So basically, it's controlling two strongholds to score points for your team. First team to 100 points wins the match.
Control two strongholds to score.
Going to Cap Red Base. Keep them off Blue Base.
Red Base secured. We lost Blue Base.
Scoring.
Hostiles captured Red Base.
enemy team scoring.
They're gonna take that.
Lost the lead.
What's your name, Sam?
Hands down. Need support.
Thanks for the help.
Down one.
We lost turbine.
Enemy controls all bases. Stronghold captured.
Get close.
Enemy team, 20-point run.
I need backup. Red base.
We lost blue base.
Enemy controls all bases. Stronghold captured.
Capture turbine.
Your team scoring.
We lost turbine.
Enemy team scoring.
Incoming grenade.
Stronghold captured.
30 seconds to sniper rifle. Power weapons in 30 seconds.
Your team scoring.
Hostiles capture red base.
Enemy team scoring.
We captured turbine.
Your team scoring.
Sniper rifles on the field. The power weapons are up. Sniper rifle.
Sniper fire, move it.
Base defense.
I need backup. Red base.
Point run.
We lost blue base. Hostiles captured red base.
Enemy team score.
Shields are full.
Stronghold captured.
We're gonna cap that.
Your team scoring.
Turbine.
Enemy team scoring.
They're gonna take red base.
Stronghold captured. Your team scoring.
Hostiles captured red base.
Enemy team scoring.
Take cover. You're one shot.
Lost the lead. Distraction.
Shields are back.
Gain the lead. Halfway to victory.
We lost blue base.
Enemy team scoring. Stronghold captured. Your team scoring. Base defense.
Sniper's up. Power weapons are up.
20-point run.
Sniper rifle's ours.
Nearing victory. Stronghold captured. All bases controlled.
Hostiles captured red base.
Nearing victory. Point run. 5 minutes remain. Stronghold captured. All bases controlled. Game over. Victory. Captured.
We're gonna cap that point. We lost blue base.
arch.
Enemy team score.
Launcher in 30 seconds.
Controls all bases. Stronghold captured. Enemy team, 20-point run. Your team scoring.
We lost red base.
Enemy team scoring.
Rockets in 30.
Taking a stronghold. I'm hit. Return fire.
Rocket launcher in 10 seconds.
Enemy controls all bases. Stronghold captured.
Rocket launchers on the field.
Enemy halfway to victory.
Hostiles captured red base.
Enemy controls all bases. Enemy team, 20-point run. Stronghold captured.
We lost blue base.
Enemy controls all bases. Victory. Enemy team, 40-point run.
Grenade incoming!
Stronghold captured.
Launcher in 30 seconds.
headshot.
Rocket launcher in 10 seconds.
Grenade out.
Enemy team, 60 points run.
Headshot. One down.
Game over. Defeat.
So there you have it, people. There was the Halo 5 Guardians Arena Multiplayer Beta with Slayer, Breakout, Strongholds. Slayer being the classic shoot them up, Breakout being slightly the same thing but without the respawns, and a more of a shiny futuristic arena styled battlefield. Strongholds, similar to Slayer but capturing the flag if you like, but staying put on a certain base and leveling it up to your team colour, being red versus blue and all that stuff. And you got to see the different sort of two variations within these maps. So there'll be loads more, I'm sure, with Halo 5 Guardians multiplayer. And so far, strangely enough, I'm liking it. I'm doing absolutely rubbish. I mean, you'd probably be better off with somebody who's like, pew, 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 and so much better. But I'm just giving you a level base, giving you a rough idea of somebody just stepping into the game. And then hopefully progressing, as you saw, my rewards got something with a sort of, I don't know, let's try it, Spartan Hub. Visor, nope, it's still Recruit. Body Armor. Air Assault. That was a new one. Yeah. Not too bad, I mean, it's the back with the difference, slightly. So that was the extra bit, and I'm sure as you progress through the game, you'll get more, so a little bit more abilities of different appearance, etc. And I'm sure there'll be loads more multiplayer maps, and that was just basically just showing you what they are as of now. So hopefully it was some enjoyment, some experience of what you got to see. And hopefully we'll get more to it when the actual game actually physically comes out. Will this be a seller? I think people will be more anticipating this game. The Master Chief Collection, good repertoire because it's one and two of those games being remastered and the other two games being a little bit more resolution wise, frames per second and so on, and all the multiplayer maps. So that game didn't get as much as hype, but it's still got a good reputation for being so many games in one, and for the people who are new to it, wow, you know, and for those who are still used to it, they got all the bundle games into one seamlessly, playing through the old version, new versions, and having everything up to par, if you like. And the multiplayer games are all in there. Moving on with the Halo 5, it'll be really interesting to see the story. That's got to be something interesting. And I'm sure it'll be really good. So jump on to the Xbox One, people, and happy gaming. Like I say, enjoy whatever you have. This is going to be a good start to it. This is where I think Microsoft will need this as a crown jewel and get people to enjoy it more. Could they do something more? Yeah, I think they could do a little bit more light-hearted stuff. I mean, that's kind of it, pretty much the games I had with the sort of middle section. I think it was the breakout version was pretty much balls in. You're gonna lose anyhow, but there's a good chance of winning, and it's more arena based. It's very in your face or very one-sided. It depends. It's that is really interesting. I hope they play around with that more. But think about it as a player, that thinking, well, I could do those maps. I could create just a few little hills and bumps and ridges, so they could really push out something special. But I doubt it. It's what it is. I'm sure you get to do your own maps into the games when it comes out as well. It'll be interesting to see what this game will come out as. But I'm sure this will be a definite enjoyment for those people on the Xbox One. So yeah, I'll be carrying on doing Skylanders Trap Team and trying to stick it to the man. Hopefully finish that. I doubt I'll be doing it, finishing in one go the next time I do it. Maybe two more or three more episodes, I don't know. Or a few viewings, what have you. And we'll see what we'll take it from there. Like I said, I do want to do Wolf Among Us and the Walking Dead series. If you've got suggestions, please do push them through. See what you like, because I like to get some feedback from you people, and it'll be really good. But it's I'm kind of just, you know, out there in the mist. So I do need some encouragement or what have you. I mean, if you're enjoying it, you're just saying you're doing great, you're doing something different, you're giving us breaks, you're giving us what it is as it is, as if somebody's jumping into the game. At least that's what I hope. And just having fun. Main thing, have fun, people. As if you need being taught. But anyway. Like I say, sometimes I do Fridays, sometimes I do Saturdays, sometimes I do both, one or the other, or neither. Don't hold me to it. I do it around about 10 PM UK time, Google further if you need to. It gives you a rough idea. The best thing to do is follow me on Twitch, and you'll get the emails. Despite that, there is Twitter, which is out there. It's kind of obvious, Alpha Wolf and all that business. And there's also, sometimes I post on Fur Affinity. Not always, because I don't like to pester the furry side. But, you know, sometimes I do. There you go. And, 1978 Wolfie YouTube channel. So thank you for watching. Hopefully you're enjoying this game as the beta version. And hopefully get to enjoy it a little bit more when the game actually comes out.